Hey everyone, what's up? My name is Jess. I am a developer advocate at Warp, and today we are going to be doing the Warp Autocomplete interview. About a week ago, Warp came out of stealth mode and launched publicly. Woo! We were number one on Hacker News, on Product Hunt, we were featured in a TechCrunch article and promoted by multiple tech TikTok creators, and retweeted by a bunch of famous Twitter people like Sarah Drasner and Kelvin Beecham Jr., who, fun fact, is an ex-NFL player. Through all of that, we got a lot of questions, a lot of comments, and we realized that as we start maturing as a company and a product, we want to make sure to bring our community along for the ride. We want our users to understand why we make certain product decisions, what we plan on working on in the future, and generally just know about all the really cool features that make Warp modern and unique. So, our team here at Warp compiled the internet's most burning questions about our product, and we're going to be addressing the top five in this video. And because we like to have a little bit of fun here at Warp, it's going to be in the format of the very popular YouTube series, the Autocomplete Interview. Let's go. All right, the lighting's a little bit different. Sorry, filming's a little bit hard sometimes, but let's get into these questions. Why is Warp only supporting Mac experience? Yes, so this is true. As of today, April 2022, Warp is only supported on Macs. Why? The answer is really just that every additional platform that we decide to support entails additional engineering overhead, which basically means that we wouldn't have as much time to build out all those cool features that we want to build. So we decided to focus on building the best terminal for one single platform, that platform being the Mac. But the good news is we do plan on adding support for web, Linux, and Windows in that order. I will add a link in the description below so you can subscribe to notifications as we build out support for all of these platforms. All right, let's do number two. Why is Warp requiring login? This is a question that we got a lot, so let me provide some context for those of you who are not as familiar with Warp. When you download Warp, it actually asks you to log in with the GitHub account. We had two main reasons for this. Number one is that we wanted to build team features in Warp, things like sharing commands with teammates or running wikis and readmes directly in the terminal. These things usually require users to have accounts. Number two is that we wanted to improve our product during beta, which is the stage that we're in right now. By having you log in, we can do things like reach out to you when we're investigating crash reports or measure aggregate feature usage. So that way we can understand which features users are engaging with the most and therefore which features are worth investing the most time into. So yeah, a lot of people were wondering about this one, understandably, because it's not something that you usually see in a terminal experience, but we think it's one of the cooler and more innovative things about Warp that really allow us to build out these cool features you don't see anywhere else. Number three, why is Warp sending telemetry events? So yeah, we do send telemetry because it basically makes it easier to reach out and get feedback when something goes wrong. However, we only track metadata. Never console input, never console output, and we do not measure your keystrokes at all. So for example, if you ran git status to see a list of edited files, Warp would not be able to see your outputted file list or even that you ran git status to begin with. What we can see is metadata, so things like the fact that you created a block to begin with. Did you read through our welcome tips? Did you change your key bindings? Did you skip our onboarding survey? These are very generic user actions that basically tell us how you're interacting with Warp, but don't really reveal any private information about you as a person. And if you want to see an exhaustive list of all the metadata that we do track, I will include the link in the bio. All right, number four, why is Warp not fully open source yet? It has been absolutely amazing getting these comments because it just shows that people are excited to really contribute to our code base and get involved. Unfortunately, open sourcing a code base does not happen overnight. It does take time and effort to prepare a code base to be open source. For example, we need to provide a development workflow. What are our design principles? How is discussion going to be facilitated? And are there actually enough developers who are willing to contribute and add code? It's a lot of work, but for those of you who are interested, we actually have open sourced certain parts of our extension points. The first one is for contributing new themes, and the second, which we added recently, allows you to contribute to our workflows, aka a list of very commonly used commands, which you can access in Warp. So I will include links to both those GitHub repos in the description below, so feel free to check them out. And last but not least, number five, why is Warp
connected to the cloud?
Yes, this is a really good question, and honestly, it's one of the things that excites me most about Warp. For an individual person like me, it means being able to sync your settings across multiple different devices. So for example, let's say I had my own personal computer where I had my terminal all set up with custom keyboard bindings and theming, and then I got a brand new MacBook for work. Instead of manually setting up my terminal again on that laptop, which could take a long time, Warp would actually allow me to sync between my personal computer and my work computer, which gets the job done a lot more quickly. For Teams, so for more collaborative environments, it means that we can build collaborative features. You could do things like asynchronously share terminal settings or command history with your team. You also get increased knowledge sharing because you can run wikis and readmes directly in the terminal. Also, you can do things like integrated password management and audit logging to make your terminal experience a lot more secure. And that's all the time we have for today. Folks, we really hope that this video answers a lot of your burning questions and helps you understand our viewpoint as a team and as a company, both from an engineering perspective and a product perspective. Our goal is to be transparent, our goal is to build a quality product, and our goal is to be awesome. We welcome feedback. Please feel free to check out our communities on Discord, Twitter, and TikTok. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to leave them in the comments of this video. We will be responding to them as a team. And for more team behind the scenes, educational content, and just updates on our product, please like this video and make sure to subscribe to our channel. It really helps a lot. See you soon!